In this video, you will learn how to find reaction forces in a simply supported beam with uniformly distributed loads. In this question, the beam is a length of 6 meters. The beam has a uniformly distributed load of 3 kN per meter and a 15 kN point load acting 2 meters away from point A. But the support reactions of R subscript A and R subscript B are unknown. We are going to find the reaction forces at the support. This roof beam is carrying a uniformly distributed load. Likewise, this lorry is carrying a uniformly distributed load along a span of 35 inches, and this is supported by the tires. Also, this ground beam is carrying a uniformly distributed structure supported by piles. Across the entire beam, the load is not uniform. However, the distributed load is uniform across different spans. The distributed load usually acts at the center of the beam, and beams are usually designed to avoid deflection. To solve this problem, step number one, we are going to draw the free body diagram for this beam. That is, we are going to multiply the distributed load, which is 3 kN, by 6. Because with 3 kN per meter, uniformly distributed load covered a span of 6 meters on the beam. When we multiply 3 by 6, the result will act at the center of the beam. The new result will remove the UDL acting on the beam. Instead of solving this question, we're going to be solving the free body diagram, where the uniformly distributed load is now acting at the center, 3 meters away from each support. For uniformly distributed load, this is the first step. Step number two, forces going up is equal to forces coming down on the beam. Let's consider the forces going up. From the free body diagram, the reaction forces pointing up are R subscript A and R subscript B respectively. Hence, I will add all the forces pointing up. Next, let's consider all the forces coming down on the beam. From the free body diagram, the forces coming down on the beam are 15 kN and 18 kN respectively. And we're going to add up all the forces coming down on the beam. And when we add 15 to 18, we're going to get 33 kN. In step number two, you can see that we have two unknown forces. Next, step number three. Clockwise moment is equal to anticlockwise moment. Alternatively, we can say that the summation of all the moments acting at a point is equal to zero. Instead of writing it in this order, we can exchange it with this formula. Both are the same. The conventional direction of a clock is towards this direction. Hence, any force that is pushing this beam up towards this direction will be acting in the clockwise direction about this point. Likewise, any force that to push this beam up towards this direction will be acting in an anti-clockwise direction, which is against the conventional clock direction. We are going to apply this clockwise and anti-clockwise conventions in the calculation, which is in step number 3. From the free body diagram, we have two reaction forces and two loads, which is a total of 4 forces on the beam. But when we take moment about point A, which will be equal to zero, hence R subscript A will be equal to zero. This statement has left us with only 3 forces, which will make it easy for us to find RB. Let's start by considering all the forces that will move the beam in the clockwise direction. Let's start with 15 kN force. And we're going to assume that the 18 kN and R subscript B does not exist at this point. The 15 kN will turn this beam in the clockwise direction, and the distance between the 15 kN to the point where we are taking our moment, which is A, is 2. Hence, instead of this formula, here I will have 15 multiplied by 2. I'm done with the 15 kN force. Next, I will consider the 18 kN force. And I will assume that the 15 kN force and R subscript B does not exist. The 18 kN force will turn this beam in the clockwise direction. And from the point of action to the point where we are taking our moment, which is point A, is 3. Hence, in the clockwise direction, we are going to have 18 multiplied by 3. Still on the clockwise direction, I will add 18 multiplied by 3 to 15 times 2, which we got earlier. Next, we're going to consider R subscript B. Let's assume that 15 kN force and 18 kN force does not exist. R subscript B will push this beam in the anti-clockwise direction, and R subscript B will be multiplied by the distance to the point where we are taking moment, which is point A, and the total distance is 6 meters, and we're going to have R subscript B multiplied by 6. And for the anti-clockwise moment, we're going to have R subscript B multiplied by 6. Moment for each force is complete. Hence, we are done with the moment, which is step number 3. Next, we're going to solve this equation to obtain the result of R subscript B. Afterwards, we're going to go to step 2, substitute for R subscript B to find R subscript A. 15 multiplied by 2 will give you 30. And 18 multiplied by 3 will give you 54. If you add 30 to 54, you are going to get 84. On the other side, you're going to get 6 multiplied by R subscript B. We are going to isolate R subscript B. And this 6 will move over to the other side to divide 84. 84 divided by 6 will give you RB, which is 14 kilonewtons. Step 4. We're going to substitute R subscript B into step 2. In step 2, where we have R subscript A plus R subscript B is equal to 33. But we now know the value of R subscript B. We know the value of RB, hence RA is equal to 19 kilonewton. RA is 19 kilonewton and RB is 14 kilonewton. If you add them both, you're going to get 33 kilonewton for the forces going up. Likewise, if you add 15 to 18, you are equally going to get 33 kilonewtons for the forces coming down. The beam is in equilibrium. And we are done with the calculation. If this video was helpful, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. To locate other helpful videos, you can follow the link on the screen. I will see you in the next video lesson.